According to the CDC, nearly 860,000 people a year die from heart disease and stroke in the United States. That's a whopping 1 in 3 deaths. With such high numbers, the chances that you are at risk of belonging to this statistic are very high. To find out if you do, let us ask you a few questions. Do you have a family history of heart disease? Do you have diabetes or are you pre-diabetic? Do you have hypertension or high blood cholesterol levels? Are you obese? Do you lead a sedentary lifestyle? Do you smoke? If you said yes to at least a third or even half of those, then we have some unfortunate news for you. You are at risk for developing heart diseases, more specifically, atherosclerosis, or narrowed and clogged arteries. It is one of the most common heart conditions, and it is also one of the most dangerous. Luckily, it is also preventable and manageable. And with the right interventions, it may even be reversible. And that's exactly what we are going to be talking about today. What you can do to prevent clogged arteries. But before we dig in, can you do us a favor? Please help us spread the word about heart disease prevention by clicking on the thumbs up icon below the video and ring the notification bell to stay up to date with our latest videos. We want to make sure you get the latest information so you can live a long, healthy life. And stick around to find out how to get 2 heart healthy free gifts. We guarantee that both you and your heart will love them. Now, let's start with getting to know what artery narrowing is. What is atherosclerosis? The Mayo Clinic defines it as the buildup of fat, cholesterol, and other substances in and on the artery walls. This buildup is called plaque. The presence of plaque causes the arteries to narrow and block blood flow. They can also burst and lead to dangerous blood clots. If this occurs in the blood vessels that supply the heart, it's called coronary artery disease. What causes clogged arteries? There are a number of factors that lead to the development of atherosclerosis. That some Mayo Clinic publication lists the following causes: high blood pressure, high blood cholesterol levels, smoking or chewing tobacco, diabetes and insulin resistance, obesity, inflammation and autoimmune conditions. Even if you have just one of these, you are already at risk. Even more so if you have multiple risk factors listed. The Mayo Clinic also notes that you are at higher risk for atherosclerosis if you have a family history of heart disease, have an unhealthy diet, lead a sedentary lifestyle, and have sleep apnea. If you have 2 or more of these factors above, the higher your risks of developing atherosclerosis are. So, why is it so dangerous? The danger of clogged arteries mainly lies in the fact that it makes it harder for the blood vessels to supply your cells with oxygen-rich blood. This can lead to symptoms such as numbness or tingling in your fingers. But that's not the worst of it. The most important reason why you should take atherosclerosis seriously is that it can lead to deadly conditions like a heart attack or stroke. You see, plaque buildup in the arteries can not only constrict blood flow, but it can also lead to blood clots. And those blood clots can dislodge and completely block blood flow to important organs, such as the heart and the brain, leading to, you guessed it, heart attacks and stroke, both deadly conditions. The Centers for Disease Control lists heart disease as the number one leading cause of death among Americans. Stroke comes in at number 5. Also, according to the CDC, heart disease, stroke, and other cardiovascular diseases are responsible for 1 in 3 deaths, or more than 859,000 deaths each year. You should therefore take clogged and narrowed arteries seriously, especially if you are looking to live healthier for longer. So, how do you know your arteries are clogged? If the narrowing of your arteries is on the mild side, chances are you won't be experiencing any symptoms. As per the Mayo Clinic, symptoms don't usually occur unless the blockage has become so severe that the supply to the organs and tissues is significantly diminished. Moderate to severe atherosclerosis can have the following symptoms: chest pain or angina, sudden numbness or weakness in your arms and legs, leg pain when walking, and sudden onset of high blood pressure and kidney failure. If you do not have symptoms but have a lot of the risk factors we've mentioned, it is safe to assume that you could have a mild form of atherosclerosis. The good thing is that treating this condition in its early stages is far easier than treating it when it becomes complicated. And that's what we're going to discuss next: how to prevent and treat clogged arteries. Are clogged arteries reversible? A July 2005 study published in the National Library of Medicine showed that in its early stages, atherosclerosis is indeed reversible. That study revealed that the key to the reversal was the lowering of the patient's blood cholesterol levels and addressing other risk factors. However, it also showed that reversal with the help of diet alone is not so easily achievable if the blockage is in the advanced stages. How are clogged arteries treated? As per John Hopkins, clogged arteries are treated with medicine and physical intervention, such as coronary angioplasty, or the use of a stent to open up an artery. Or if the clogs are in the coronary arteries, the suggested treatment route is coronary artery bypass surgery. Johns Hopkins, however, also underlines the effectiveness and necessity of lifestyle changes to address and affect some of the risk factors that can worsen the condition. Some of what they recommend include: stop smoking, lowering blood cholesterol levels, lowering blood pressure, controlling blood sugar levels, exercising, and improving your diet. Are there any home remedies for clogged arteries? Yes, there are. But we don't want to emphasize that if you have already been diagnosed with atherosclerosis and if your doctor has given you medications and laid out a treatment plan for you, you should follow through with that. Any additional home remedy you choose to follow will just be an add-on to your current treatment. You should also discuss any alternative treatment plan you may want to undertake with your healthcare provider. That being said, yes, there are a number of home remedies that can help you address atherosclerosis. St. Luke's Hospital in Chesterfield, Missouri, released a list of complementary treatments for atherosclerosis. These include adapting a better diet. They recommend the Mediterranean diet, increasing antioxidant intake, increase omega-3 fatty acid intake, exercising at least 30 minutes a day, 6 days a week, maintaining a normal weight, losing weight if necessary, reduce stress, and managing blood sugar, blood pressure, and blood cholesterol levels. You can also look to herbs and natural remedies to help you address some of the factors that put you at risk for developing clogged arteries. For example, antioxidants are beneficial in helping you address the inflammation that can aggravate the condition. One of the best and readily available antioxidants you can get your hands on is vitamin C. One of the most reliable sources of vitamin C out there are lemons and other citrus fruits. Numerous studies, including a 2021 study from J. Agric Food Chem and published in the National Library of Medicine, showed that citrus fruits have significant cardiovascular protective properties. Another study, this one from 2000, showed evidence that vitamin C may decrease the risk of stroke. Another food item that has shown promise in helping reduce blood cholesterol levels and lowering your chances of developing clogged arteries is garlic. A 1997 study showed that garlic can indirectly affect atherosclerosis by improving some of its risk factors, such as hypertension and high blood cholesterol levels. There are also studies that look into the efficiency of these two used together. But before we get into this, Heart Disease Code would love to give you a free book: The Surprising Truth About Fat and Cholesterol, plus the first episode of The Untold Story of Heart Disease. This is something that everyone concerned about heart health should watch. Simply click the link in the description below to claim these free gifts. So, lemon and garlic together, does it work? You may have heard of this mixture already, but did you know that it is backed up with solid research? A 2016 study sought to discover the effect that garlic and lemon juice had on the lipid profiles and cardiovascular risk factors for people between 30 and 60 years of age who had moderate hyperlipidemia or elevated blood cholesterol levels. The study showed that there was a significant decrease in the cholesterol levels of the study participants. In addition, a decrease in their blood pressure and weight was also observed. How does this mixture prevent clogged arteries? Prevention is better than cure, and we all know that. In addition, prevention is also easier than cure. This is especially true in the case of atherosclerosis. An advanced case of vascular disease is often irreversible, but you can prevent it from getting any worse. If you are not showing symptoms of it yet, or even if you already are and you don't want it to get any worse, it is a good idea to look at preventative measures. One way to prevent clogged arteries from happening is to address some of its risk factors, including high blood cholesterol levels, high blood pressure, obesity, and inflammation. All of these can be addressed with lemon and garlic taken individually or together. How to take lemon and garlic together? In the 2016 study we mentioned, the researchers had the participants take 1 tablespoon of freshly squeezed lemon juice and 20 grams or roughly 4 teaspoons of garlic a day for 8 weeks. The results showed that the cholesterol levels of those who took lemon and garlic daily dipped dramatically. If you are going to be taking this mixture yourself, be sure to not add any additional sugar to your lemon and take it freshly squeezed. As for garlic, don't cook it as that can affect its antioxidant properties. If you find it hard to stomach garlic and lemon straight up, you may consider making up a garlic and lemon drink that may be able to offer the same benefits but is much more palatable. Now, we just want to jump in here with a quick reminder though. Any alternative remedy you decide to take, be it this or another, should not replace any of your current medical interventions. If you are unsure of how your supplemental treatments can affect your medications, it is better to discuss them with your healthcare provider. At this point, you may be thinking, garlic and lemon, got it. But are there other natural remedies or interventions that you can do to help prevent clogged arteries? Absolutely. On top of the list is making changes to what you eat. Mayo Clinic and other health institutes recommend a diet high in fiber, fruits, and vegetables. They suggest adhering to the Mediterranean diet as it is high in fiber, in good fats, and is low in sugars and red meats. You can also add foods rich in antioxidants to your diet. These can include red and purple fruits and veg, avocados, certain berries, and more. Avoid overly processed foods and go for whole grain and whole food options whenever possible. Lifestyle change is also important too. In a 2020 study published in the European Journal of Preventive Cardiology, they recommended that to prevent heart disease, you need to address the risk factors first. This includes making sure that you have a healthy body weight, your blood pressure levels are in check, your blood sugar levels are managed well, your blood cholesterol levels are in the normal range, you exercise regularly. They also recommend that you don't smoke, you get enough good quality sleep, and you avoid stress. These recommendations can be achieved with the help of dietary and lifestyle changes. If you follow these, then you should be able to successfully prevent clogged arteries. And as I mentioned, we're running a special on the Heart Disease Code program. The Heart Disease Code is a comprehensive guide to help you prevent and fight heart disease. It was created by over 40 health experts and includes a 9-part documentary series looking at how to improve blood pressure naturally. It sets the record straight on cholesterol and explains in everyday English the science of how to reduce the risk of heart attack, stroke, diabetes, and more. Plus, you'll get the Heart Healthy Cookbook, where our in-house chef worked with nutritionists and doctors to give you heart-healthy recipes. They are delicious and can be whipped up in no time. Plus, you'll get a ton of great information about supplements, food lists, and much more. To check it out, click the link in the description below or go to heartdisease.code.com. And remember to like this video and click the subscribe button so that you can stay up to date as we release new videos. Thanks for watching. We hope you have a happy and heart-healthy day.